Welcome to Excel Crafters, the Microsoft Excel tutorial channel. By the end of this video, you will be able to type subscripts and superscripts in various elements of a graph or a chart, which is the title, axis titles, and even in the legends. We will also look at how to type in degree symbol in the graph or chart titles and legends. And most importantly, we will also look at subscripts and superscript implementation in graphs using Excel shortcuts. If you would like to skip to a particular portion of this video, please refer the index given in the video description. And also note that the Excel that I'm going through in this video is available for you to download, and the link is provided in the video description. Hope you'll enjoy the video. So now let's get started. This is the data set that we have used to create the below chart. The first column is the plot ID, second is the state, third is the actual location, and fourth column is the area of the plot, and this is the average summer temperature. So assume that this is all the locations where I have real estate in, or you have real estate in. What I've done here is I've created one chart which shows the area versus the city where I have the plot in, and the second one is the average temperature of all these cities. So let's try first adding a chart title and see how we can add subscripts or superscripts there. First, let's go ahead and click on this chart elements. So you're going to add a new chart element, which is the chart title, right? So you can see a chart title has come here. So let's edit the title. So let's see how we can implement superscripts and subscripts. In this case, where there was an M2 in a normal cell in the Excel, if you do a right click, you have an option to select format cells. And then there was easy access to either superscript or subscript. However, when it comes inside a graph, you don't have such an option. If you do a right click, you don't get that format cell option here. So the only way you can implement superscripts or subscripts is either using shortcuts or by just copy pasting the values. Let's look at all the three options. The first option that we will walk through is to use a quick shortcut, but this will work only for the superscript 1, 2, 3 and the degree. So let's look at making this a superscript. Select the 2, or you can just delete it and then key press the alt key and type in 0178 and then release the alt key. So now if you see, square has come in the chart title. So this was one way of doing it. Now let's see the second way. You can delete this superscript. Let's select 2, do a control C to copy that value, come back into the chart title, select where you want to paste it, and then do a control V. See, here again you are able to copy paste the values directly. Now I have given all the possible values here in this Excel sheet, so you can choose to copy directly from here to your chart and you get access to all these values. There is the actual source from where I copied these values, so let's look at that. This is the actual source from where I copied it. So what you can do is, say for example you want to copy the superscript 4, just select that, do a control C, go back to your chart and do a control V. See, you are able to paste that superscript value. You can bookmark this link and then use it whenever you want it. So we looked at option 1, option 2, and the third option is using the shortcuts. In case of shortcut, you have to type in 2 if you want to make it a meter square, and then what you do is alt HFNP for superscript, and if you see here, this has become meter square. Similarly, if you want to make this a subscript, same thing, alt HFNB to make it a subscript. Another way of doing it is Control 1 and then leave a control, then hold Alt P and release the Alt key and becomes a meter square. So next we look at how to implement superscript or subscript in the axis title. You go to chart elements plus and then select axis title. So you will see a vertical and a horizontal axis title has come here. So horizontal, we'll just go ahead and type in as location, and the vertical we will give it as area and in bracket meter square. It is exactly similar to how we did it for the chart title. In this case, I'll just go through a shortcut method, but you can use all the three methods to use it. Select the two and key press Alt HFNP for superscript. Okay, and it becomes a superscript. Now the third and the last place where you may need to include a superscript or subscript is in the legend. The legend is not directly editable, so you are able to edit the values in the axis title, you are able to edit the values in the chart title, but in the legend you cannot directly edit it. So legend will be same as the column header. The column header should carry the exact value what you want to show up in legend. Now you edited this to meter square. Now if you see, it has come in here as we have given in the column header. So that means if you have to make this to a subscript, you have to do it at the column header itself. Let's look at two ways where it would not work. If you select two and right click format cells and make it a superscript, okay, it looks good here, but actually if you come to the chart, it has not changed. This did not work, and the reason why it did not work is if you see the actual value in the cell, see here the actual value, it is still showing up as 2, correct? So the chart label is taking the value in the cell. So that is why, even though it looks like a subscript here in the label, it still comes as M2. If you had seen earlier the shortcuts, right, it is replicating the same steps, doing a right click and format cells and selecting superscript or subscript. So that would mean even the shortcut method would not work here. Let's see if the copy paste would work. So if you copy the value and put it here, yes, so the copy paste would work here, because if you see the value now, it is actually showing as a superscript. So if you go to the chart, yes, the label is reflecting properly. This is one option that you have, where you can just directly copy paste these values to the column header. Second option is to use these shortcuts. Again, if you want to make it a meter square, what you do is hold the Alt key 0178 and then release the Alt key. So again, it becomes meter square. And if you see, the value holds the actual superscript value and the label contains the superscript. Now let's quickly replicate this into a second chart, where I want you to look at how we can implement degrees. So let's first bring in all the components that we need, that is the axis title, chart title and legend. Let me quickly edit it. Axis title. Now I have to include a degree there. We'll do that. Okay, so let's start with this degree. In order to bring in degree, there's only one way you can do it, which is this. Click where you want the degree sign to come, press the Alt key and type in 0176 and release the Alt key. If you see, the degree Fahrenheit has come in, looks good. Then next thing is the average summer temperature you want to bring degree Fahrenheit even in this case, right? Same thing, you have to click here, press Alt 0176, release the Alt key, degree has come in, and if you see, degree Fahrenheit is showing up in the legend also. So great, I think we have covered everything that you need to bring in a superscript or a subscript anywhere in your chart. I would like to have a conversation with you. If you have any query, or if you want to shower some praises for this wonderful video, or if you want to criticize this video, whatever it might be, I would appreciate if you can drop a note in the comment so that we can have a good interaction. If you like the video, please like it, and I would be posting comprehensive tutorials like these in different areas of Excel. So if you want to be a part of this channel, please subscribe and click the bell button so that you will get notified whenever I publish a new video. Thank you so much for your time. Bye, and have a great rest of the day ahead.